Hello everyone, welcome to Study IQ. Let's start the current affairs for 27th of August. Please note that only a few hours to go till our sale ends, so make best use of it in the next 4 to 5 hours. India and which country has signed an agreement? They have signed an agreement, a second protocol, amending the Comprehensive Economic Cooperation Agreement. It was first signed in the year 2005, then it was subsequently amended. And this is the second protocol amending the same. It is Singapore. This will boost the trade between India and Singapore. Singapore's Prime Minister is Lee Hsien Loong. And their first ever female president is Halima Yacoob. Which country's cyber town will be named after former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee? Which country's cyber town? It is Mauritius. Mauritius' capital is Port Louis. It lies in the Indian Ocean. And Mr. Praveen Jagannath is the Prime Minister of Mauritius. He will also inaugurate on 9th of January 2019 Pravasi Bharatiya Divas in India along with Pradhan Mantri Modi. Now there are a lot of things that are being named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji. Maybe it is a strategy or a ploy to cash in on his death. But okay, whatever reasons. Jawaharlal Nehru University, JNU, has announced that they will rename their School of Management and Entrepreneurship after Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji. Now it will be called Atal Bihari Vajpayee School of Management and Entrepreneurship. Chhattisgarh CM Raman Singh, he said that Naya Raipur, the capital of Chhattisgarh, will be named Atal Nagar. Bundelkhand Expressway, right, will now be called Atal Path, announced by Yogi Adityanath. Then Deogar is in Jharkhand. It's a very important town in Jharkhand district, in fact. So there is an airport that will be set up at Deogar and it will be called Atal Bihari Vajpayee Airport. The list does not end here. There is an AIMS in Andhra called AIMS Mangalagiri. It will be named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji. There is a tunnel in Himachal Pradesh called Rohtang Tunnel. It will be named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji. And so will be Habibganj Railway Station. It will also be named after Atal ji. Now remember, Habibganj Railway Station is the first private railway station in India managed by a company called Bansal Group. In Assam, we have over river Brahmaputra, something known as Bogi Bill Bridge. This bridge is yet to be inaugurated, but it will be called Atal Setu now. Bogi Bill Bridge will be named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Some more. So there's a medical college in Palamo. There's a Palamo Tiger Reserve also. Palamo is basically name of a place in Jharkhand. Now it will be called Atal Bihari Vajpayee Medical College. Similarly, Convention Center in Ranchi will be called Atal Convention Center. Jharkhand Innovation Lab will be called Atal Innovation Lab. And Sahibganj Harbour will be called Atal Bihari Vajpayee Harbour. Sahibganj is the only district in Jharkhand that is drained by River Ganga. Okay. The Holy Ganges touches district Jharkhand Sahibganj district. Which contract has been launched by Indian Air Force for speedy delivery of consignment? This contract is called SpeedX. Now remember, Indian Air Force Chief is B.S. Dhanoa, Navy Chief is Sunil Lamba, and Army Chief is Bipin Rawat. What is the full form of SpeedX? It is called the Stores Proactive, Efficient and Expeditious Dispatch of Extra Size or WT Consignment. What is the theme of this contract? The theme is called Lift, Shift and Move. Lift, Shift and Move. Now, I want to ask you a question. Who organized Move Hack? Move Hack. Who organized it? Write down in comments. The government of Telangana, they have increased the free power that they give to the SCST family, Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe families, from 50 units to how much? They will now give, instead of 50, they have doubled it. So they will give 101 unit. Remember, it is not 100, it is 101. So you will find 100 unit also in the options. CM is Chandrasekhar Rao, ruling party is called Telangana Rashtriya Samiti, capital is Hyderabad. Now two important decisions more are taken. First is that the imam, you know, the what you call the Muslim priests, right, imams and the mozains of the masjid, they were given 1500 rupees per month honorarium. Now it has been increased to 5000 rupees. And the pujari or the priest in the temples, their retirement age was 58 in Telangana. Now it has been increased to 65. Ninth edition of Mountain Echoes Literary Festival. It's a very, very important literary festival, Mountain Echoes, right? So it was recently held in which country? It was held in Bhutan. Why was this important? Because it marks 50 years of diplomatic ties between India and Bhutan. Now, this word always reminds me of a novel. And the mountains echoed. Who has written? And the mountains echoed. Who has written this novel? Write down in comments. And by the way, the person who has written this novel, his upcoming novel, what is the name of it? Okay. Write down in comments. I asked this question 3 days back. The World Bank has launched the world's first public bond created and managed using blockchain technology. What is the name of this bond? By the way, this bond is named after a beach. So it is called Bondi Bond. Okay. Bondi is the name of a beach in Sydney, Australia. And remember the full form of Bondi. Full form is blockchain operated new debt instrument. And the Commonwealth Bank of Australia is the sole manager of the deal. By the way, this time the Commonwealth Games happened in Australia only, in Queensland, Gold Coast. Who has been appointed as the new chairman of Defence Research Development Organisation? If you remember, Dr. S. Christopher was the chairman, right? Then he resigned. So his position was taken by Sanjay Mitra. Sanjay Mitra is our Defence Secretary right now. But he was given only temporary chairmanship. So we were looking for a replacement for S. Christopher. And now we have got a suitable replacement in G. Satish Reddy. Who has been appointed as the head of a 3-member committee to decide the mining company Vedanta's plea challenging the closure of its copper sterlite plant at Tuticorin in Tamil Nadu? That committee has been constituted by National Green Tribunal. So basically, I'll tell you what happened. There is a copper sterlite plant of a company called Vedanta. Okay. Now Vedanta's chairman is Anil Agarwal. It's a company based in UK, but has businesses in India, of course. Now National Green Tribunal had said that the company's plant in Tuticorin or Thoothukudi in Tamil Nadu, it is causing heavy pollution, and because of that people are getting cancer because of the polluted water. The children are being born with the deformities and so on. There were protests against this plant and finally it was shut down. Now they have challenged it in court. So National Green Tribunal has made a committee which will basically decide whether the plant will be closed or not and how to counter this plea and all that. And National Green Tribunal chairman is AK Goyal, Adarsh Kumar Goyal. So, but the chairman of this committee is SJ Wazifdar. India's only aircraft carrier. So you know that India has only one aircraft carrier, right? What is it called? It will be fitted with now a marine hydraulic system to boost the air operations of the ship. It is called INS Vikramaditya. And it was made with the help of Russia. In fact, this hydraulic system will also be put by Russia. Who has become the first woman fighter pilot in Japan? Her name is Misa Matsushima. Misa Matsushima. Now, if I ask about India then. So remember, Avani Chaturvedi is India's first female fighter pilot. Pay attention to this word, fighter pilot. If they ask, who is India's first female naval pilot? Then the answer is Shubhangi Swarup. Okay, she is first naval woman pilot. And first fighter pilot is Avani Chaturvedi. And Meghna Schoenbog, she is South India's first woman fighter pilot. Right? Meghna Schoenbog is from Chikmagaluru in Karnataka. Avani Chaturvedi is from Rewa, Madhya Pradesh. And Shubhangi Swarup is from Bareilly, Uttar Pradesh. The Department of Telecommunication, which is called DOT in short, it has reportedly said that people will be able to make calls and use the internet during flights up to 30,000 feet height. From when? They will be able to use it starting October 2018. So India is one of those rare countries which does not allow the use of internet in while you are flying by plane because of security concerns. But most of the countries, they allow it. In fact, you can make calls also from plane. Whereas we have to put the phone in what you call the air mode, right? But a lot of countries allow. And also remember that Telecom Regulatory Authority of India chairman is Ram Sevak Sharma. Okay, R.S. Sharma is the chairman of TRAI. Who has launched an initiative to assess the damage to the rich cultural and the tangible heritage in the flood devastated Kerala and set up an emergency response platform? So basically, it's like this, you know, in Kerala, because of the floods, a lot of monuments, a lot of sites, a lot of heritage, they have destroyed. So who will make an analysis of all that? It is ICOMOS. It is called International Council for Monuments and Sites. ICOMOS. Now, from America, a very, very famous person. He was a senator from Arizona and two-time contender for the presidency. He passed away recently. What was his name? His name was John McCain. Very, very important. When Obama became president for the first time, he beat John McCain in the elections. Obama is a Democrat. John McCain was a Republican. And right now, the ruling party is the Republican Party, Donald Trump being the president. Hurricane has struck. Okay, the name of the hurricane is Lane. Hurricane Lane has struck where? Now, you can see word hurricane is used near America, especially in the North Pacific Ocean. So, it has struck Hawaii. Where is Hawaii? So, you can see this is the North American continent. This is the South American continent. This is the Central America. And to the east of it, you will have the West Indies, the Caribbean. And right here in the Pacific Ocean, you have Hawaii. It's a group of various islands like Honolulu, Kalawao, Maui. And the largest one is called Hawaii, but overall also it is called Hawaii. So it lies in the Pacific Ocean. What was the name of the former Indian batsman and Bengal captain who passed away recently in Birmingham? His name was Gopal Bose. And he has, by the way, played only one one-day match for India. That was against England. But he was famous for other things. Like he was the manager of the Indian team when we won the World Cup in 2008. And he was a Ranji Trophy player. He was a domestic cricket player, Gopal Bose. Who will be honored with 2018 Asia Game Changer of the Year? Who is the Game Changer of the Year? Indra Nooyi. Indra Nooyi was, pay attention to this word, was the CEO of PepsiCo. She was the global CEO of PepsiCo. And now her position will be taken by Ramon Laguarta. Ramon Laguarta is the new CEO of PepsiCo. And Ramon Laguarta is from Spain. In which city did the Quit India movement begin? Quit India movement began from a place called Gawala Tank, which is in Mumbai. The year was 1942. The Mansabdari system was introduced by which person? It was used by Akbar. Can you tell me, there is a place near Agra, okay, around 25 kilometers away from Agra, where Akbar established his capital. What is the name of that place? It starts with the letter F. The French Revolution started in which year? It started in 1989, it ran till 1799. And three words, liberty, equality, and fraternity, they were taken from the French Revolution. Which country's government has banned the first class air travel by officials and leaders, including the president and their prime minister, as part of the austerity measure? So basically, Imran Khan, the new prime minister of Pakistan, has said that the ministers will not fly first class. As per the Finmin report, which bank has been ranked at the top among the, all the public banks in digital transaction? Even after so many mishaps in terms of economic offenses, you know, this bank still is at the top among digital transaction. It is Punjab National Bank. And remember, the tagline is a bank, I mean, you can bank upon. PNB is non-executive chairman. PNB's non-executive chairman is Sunil Mehta. And if you remember, there was a Sunil Mehta committee also for resolution of the non-performing assets. And it gave a project called Shashakt, which in English means empowered. Project Shashakt, which gave a 5-point resolution plan for non-performing assets. So that's it. See you once again tomorrow.